Even on your favorite websites, you were probably annoyed at some point. A missing feature, irritating design, or simply slow development. Good news, it is actually possible to fix many of these yourself. Here are 5 browser add-ons to make the world's most popular websites even better. For the fans of free knowledge, WikiWand transforms the plain look of Wikipedia into a more modern design with a better layout. It adds a more readable font, larger images and cover photos, and a useful sidebar for quickly jumping to different sections of an entry. You can immediately see where you are because it follows your reading. There's a quick preview when hovering over links, and you only need to double tap the left control key to access the multi-language search. There are more display options accessible at the top, for example a dark mode as well as the possibility to adjust layout and font size. All photos of an article can be viewed in an image gallery, and WikiWand also has a great mobile website optimized for touch control. You can switch back to classic Wikipedia using the W icon at the top. For anyone who spends time on YouTube, there's the add-on Enhancer for YouTube. It adds a toolbar to manage its settings, but you can also uncheck all items to hide it. Enhancer can enlarge the video player for you, change the playback speed of a video and even ads, with finer control than the default YouTube settings. You can select a preferred playback quality, enable a mini player while reading comments, and remove ads with the ability to whitelist your favorite YouTube channels so they can continue to produce great videos. It's also possible to use the mouse wheel to control volume and playback speed and auto-pause when another video is playing in a background tab. There are custom themes, scripts and keyboard shortcuts, so it's best you go through the settings yourself and enable what you need. Facebook users might like the extension Social Fixer. It filters the newsfeed and subscriptions by keywords, author, and even HTML classes. Pre-made filters include hiding sponsored stories and political content. Unfortunately, I can't show you much because I'm not a Facebook user anymore, but aside from many convenience features like switching feeds, filtering comments and showing exact timestamps, you can also anonymize screenshots automatically, display Facebook's AI keywords on photos, and style the website using custom CSS. Social Fixer is available as an extension, but also as a user script, which I will show you more of later. Very similar, but for Reddit users, is the Reddit Enhancement Suite. It is impossible to mention all the features, and several were already made obsolete by the redesign in 2018. Switching between multiple accounts, infinite scrolling, and filtering posts are just some of the options this add-on has introduced. It is basically aimed at power users who still prefer to use Reddit's old design. It adds additional links, can change buttons and enables a command line for quickly switching subreddits, navigating profiles and submitting content. Highlighting and tagging users, a live comment preview, night mode, inline image preview, Reddit Enhancement Suite implements anything the new design does and more. Finally, let's talk about user scripts. For Firefox there's the add-on Grease Monkey, and Chrome and Safari have the extension Tamper Monkey. Both add-ons can run custom JavaScript called user scripts on pretty much any website, so the possibilities for customization are endless. If you don't want to write any scripts yourself, there is greasyfork.org, a collection of hundreds of user scripts. Many scripts are for Chinese websites, but there are also useful additions to YouTube, Google, DuckDuckGo, Steam, and many more. One of my favorites is YouTube HD, a script that resizes the YouTube player to my preferred size. These scripts can be updated automatically just like browser add-ons, and they don't rely on a web store to be published, so you can basically get them from anywhere. Be careful to only install scripts from sources that you trust though, because in theory, they could be malicious and manipulate banking websites or get their hands on other private information. Scripts on GreasyFork often have feedback, so while it's easy to just click install, be sure to also read the ratings and comments. You can easily share and edit user scripts you have added from the dashboard, So if you know some JavaScript, it wouldn't hurt to check if the script is doing what it's supposed to do. Now go on, tweak some websites, and then come back next week for a new video.